Are you deciding between SmartSuite and Airtable and you want to make sure that you start with the right software for you? Well, if so, you are going to love this video because I am going to be walking through the five key ways that SmartSuite beats Airtable every time. Now, I want to be fully transparent. I am not doing a SmartSuite versus Airtable for this video. I am going to be singing the praises of SmartSuite and showing you the five key reasons they are the better software. Now, to be fair, we're going to include a part two to this video where we show you the five key ways that Airtable's a better software. So if you haven't already, be sure you subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss out on that video when it comes out. But for now, let's get on into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no code. If you love no code like we do, you are going to love this video because we are diving into the things that make SmartSuite an incredibly powerful tool, specifically better than Airtable, focusing on these five key features. But before I get started, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is the cornerstone of understanding no code. And if you haven't already gone through the key fundamentals of automation, you are going to benefit wildly from this training. It's going to save you so much time. So grab that training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. I will go ahead and share links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and start talking about the five key ways that SmartSuite beats Airtable. And I also want to invite you to join me to follow along here inside of your own SmartSuite account. You can replicate all the things that I'm about to show you here. If you don't already have SmartSuite, be sure to use our link wherever you found this video. Give us a little bit of credit, show some love back to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Let's go ahead and hop into my number one reason that I love SmartSuite over Airtable, and it's because of dynamic filtering. What is that? Let's take a look. Here I have a table for states. I've listed only two states, Colorado and Texas. And I've linked these states to cities that exist in these states. So as you can see, Colorado is linked to Denver, Aurora, etc. Texas here is linked to El Paso, Fort Worth, etc. So these cities live in another table. This is a second table, and you can see that right here. Here's Arvada, Aurora, etc., and respectively, the city is linked back to the state because that's how a database works. You connect one thing over here, then it's connected in both places. I've also brought in the capital here. So I'm starring Denver, I'm starring Austin, the capital cities of these two states. Now, why is this cool? Well, check out our third table called submission. Over here in submissions, we link to a state. And when we link to a state, then we're going to link to a city. And what we want is to be certain that when we link to a city, it's a city that belongs in that state. So when I open up my city options, I only want to see those cities in Colorado. When I open up this one down here, I only want to see those cities in Texas. Isn't this pretty important inside of a relational database? Well, surprisingly, Airtable does not have this functionality. This is called dynamically filtered linking, where what shows up on our linked relationship option is filtered dynamically based on other stuff that's already been linked, like the state. So for us, what we do here in SmartSuite, as you see, I can click here. Remember that my state for this record is Colorado, and I only see Colorado cities. I can also control what is showing up on this linked record. So I can actually see the capital here as well because I've opted to bring that in. Now, if I were to look at the Texas record down here where we've selected Texas already, I'm going to get a different experience. I only see those Texas cities because of this dynamic filtered linking. So how do we set this up? Well, inside of SmartSuite, we can go into the second of the two linked relationships. We've linked to state, that's our first one, and we've linked to city. So we can click into any of these linked cells here, double click, and it's going to open up the settings for our linked relationship. And up here in the upper right corner, we have the record selector settings. And if we click here, we see the fields that we're allowed to bring in, the sorting that we have, as well as the filter. So because I'm most excited about the filter, I'm going to show that first. We go here and we say, we want to bring in and filter out the cities where the state includes this. We want to filter those in, rather. And anywhere that the state does not equal the state that we've already linked to, then we don't want that particular city to show up. Now we can also impact the sorting, and here I've chosen alphabetical, so we're sorting our city names in alphabetical order, and I've also included what is getting brought in here to show up. The state, the city name, and the capital are all showing up when I'm looking at my linked fields. These are linked settings that we do not have inside of Airtable. Importantly to me is this dynamic filter here, the sorting and the fields. They're nice to haves, but they're not critical to so many different business functions. But dynamic filtered links, this is critical to so many business functions. For example, you might pick a client and then want to filter down automatically to only addresses that belong to that client. You can't do that in Airtable without an enormous workaround, but in SmartSuite, it is all part of the software natively. Now, the second key feature that I absolutely love from SmartSuite is the capability to link to any table anywhere inside of your SmartSuite account. This is not possible in Airtable, but it is so, so important, especially for growing organizations, to be able to connect to their data across a bunch of solutions. As you use tools like Airtable and SmartSuite more and more, you're going to find that multiple different departments within your organization adopt the tool. In so many situations with our clients, we've seen examples where a tool like Airtable will be adopted by the marketing team, but ultimately starts getting used by operations and finance and accounting. Like, there's so many different ways that you can use these tools, and you're going to build separate solutions to manage related data, especially when it comes to department silos. So why is this such an important thing? Well, if I want to link up to clients or contacts, right here inside of this, you see that I don't have access to that data. Well, I can simply come in and build a linked relationship here. So I'll simply say linked record. And not only can I see the different tables inside of this solution, so states, cities, and submission, well, I can actually pick other tables as well. Outside of this particular system, I can look at all of my different places where I've stored all this information. These are all the tables across my account. Now, I should say that this is a demo account, so it doesn't have any live real data here, but I can look at this particular one called SmartSuite Features. That's the name of the solution. It's not this one. It's a totally different solution, but I can still link to the data in there. And simply by adding this, I have now brought in a link to clients, and I can see data that lives in a totally different solution somewhere unrelated to what I'm working to here. So here you can see that it's actually coming up with this red accent color, and that's an indication that this lives somewhere else, because here in the solution I'm working in, you see it's blue, and this data lives in a different solution, a red solution, but I can still link to it, I can still make that selection, and I can even open that record information up and see that information right here. Here's a signature for this particular record. You know, I can drop files and images in. I can access this data just like I can access anything else. And this allows us to work cross-functionally in SmartSuite way more simply than we can in Airtable. So inside of Airtable, if you're comparing the two tools, you have to create what's called a synced table. So the data basically gets mirror copied into another place, and it's this long unnecessary step that slows down the sharing of data. SmartSuite has a streamlined approach that lets you build faster, deploy faster, and collaborate better because of the fact that you can link across any solution and connect tables together. Now, the third reason that I love SmartSuite over Airtable has to do with my work. Again, this has to do with a lot of that cross-functional work. So my work is a section inside of SmartSuite. In the upper right corner of our account, we can click here and see anything that we've been assigned to as a task across all of the different SmartSuite solutions that we are a part of. So as I mentioned, this is a demo account. Under normal circumstances, you won't find 20 different solutions here, maybe 2, 3, 4. But I can go into any one of those solutions and look at different tasks that have been assigned to me that are not yet completed. And I can resolve them, I can complete them right from here. But as soon as I update the status here to be complete, this record is going to disappear from my open assignments, and I will now find it over here in my closed assignments. So this is really powerful because as we work, In different solutions throughout an organization, people might assign us tasks. If I'm in the marketing team and finance needs me for a particular reason, they can add me to a task. I can see that show up in my work, and I can know all of the things I need to do consolidated in that one space. Without having to click around and go into five or six different solutions, I have all of my tasks in that one place, allowing me to get more done more efficiently. Now, the fourth reason I love SmartSuite over Airtable has to do with permissions. Inside of Airtable, if I'm sharing access to a database, I'm sharing access to the whole thing. There's no way for me in Airtable to say, hey, I want you to just see this one table without using a complicated interface that I have to build on top of it. So in SmartSuite, this is not the case. In SmartSuite, I can share access to a solution, yes. Right here in permissions, I can choose how people are going to have access to this. I can choose if it's going to be private to me, or maybe I want to give all members access, or I can share with specific teams, or if I want to go even deeper, get into advanced permissions. At advanced permissions, I can exclude or include specific teams and members and choose what kind of access they have. Maybe not full access. As you can see, I have a lot of control. Full access, editor, contributor, assignee, commenter, or viewer. I can share very granular permissions with the different people on my team across different departments, and it makes sharing that much simpler. But that's not all. This is great, sure. This is solution level permissions, but every layer in my data has the same access to permissions. So inside my tables, check it out, more permissions. Inside here, I can say, you know, by default, it's going to inherit the same permissions from the solution, but I can override. If I want to override and change and say, you know what, actually somebody on my team can see this solution, but they can't see this particular table. So I have the ability to include or exclude certain people from seeing that information at a table level. And if that's not cool enough, I can do the same thing at the field level. So here at the field where I've built the link to clients, I can edit permissions again and still decide who can edit and who can view this field. So this is taking permissions to the next level. Now, as I mentioned, Airtable does allow you to create an interface and you can share that interface with particular people on your team. And so yes, you can control what they see, you can control what they edit, but that interface is an additional layer of complexity that SmartSuite does not require you to mess with. So inside of SmartSuite, you can just boom, right inside the solution itself, control those permissions, and you don't have to worry about that extra layer of stuff on top. Now, the fifth thing I love about SmartSuite that Airtable does not have, it really comes down to how you view your records. So here in this record, you can see that I have all these fields that are hiding, and these are the fields that I'm showing. So I've got count, state, city, and a link to the clients. But there's some other stuff back here about when this record was first created, if there is a task associated with this record, the comments, etc. I've hidden all of this because I like a streamlined view, but it's still there underneath the surface. Well, when we expand the record, you're going to see all of this information. So here's the status, here's the assigned to for the task, the due date, and all of this is customizable in terms of how we visualize the record in its expanded view. Check this out. We can go here to the action menu and we can choose to add a section. And so here I might have the section of city and state. And inside of this section, as you see, I can collapse it. Right now, all of this information lives in the section, but I might not want that to be the case. So here I can say, let's bring in another section here, and this will be everything else. So in order to move them, I'm going to hover over here and in the top left corner, grab this field and bring it up into another section. Drop it into city state. I'm going to get rid of the description. I don't need that. And let's find the state here. Again, click drag. And I also want to point out while I'm doing this that we again see that color coding that is telling us this link to clients, that lives somewhere else. That is in a different solution, a different database, but I still have access to it here because of the fact that my linking is across any solution. Now that I've got my sections kind of set up, I can come in here and set up some rules. So I might collapse the everything else by default. And here I can keep the city state section open. So let's go ahead and save these changes. And you'll see what I mean. When I open up another record here inside, it's going to show me just the stuff in the sections that I want to see. And it's not that we deleted the other stuff, it's still here and I can look at it. If this information is relevant in certain cases, maybe I'm accessing it only under specific conditions. But by default, I can change the way that people are interacting with the data and bringing the most important data up to the top. This is something that we cannot do in Airtable with the same amount of flexibility that we can in SmartSuite. So it makes it that much harder when people are expanding the different records in Airtable to make sure that they're seeing the information that they really need at that moment in time. Hey, I know we went fast on covering my five favorite features where SmartSuite beats Airtable, but if this has convinced you that you need to give SmartSuite a shot, please use our affiliate link. As I mentioned earlier, it's a great way for you to show some love back to the channel. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.